Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
to take a few weeks off and just tour the country a little bit. Well, you know, I inherited that money from my dad.
I know you can hear me, Mom. I'll swing by later and we have a steak, okay? Okay. Ciao, Mama. Bye.
I'm here now, ready to meet up with Sierra Knox over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. I've just got to pick up the documents from my van, but I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit. Now I can't find my car keys. Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost him in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. Talk soon.
A disgruntled Kronstadt employee has acquired some dirt on Sierra Knox and intends on blackmailing her. Disguised as one of the racing mascots, he plans to meet Sierra by the old motel.
Have you seen my mascot outfit?
Oh, my head is killing me.
Thank you.
would be really shitty because I got that chess tournament coming up this weekend.
maybe we should screw Knox over. Maybe we could do something bad. If he's the asshole you say he is, he doesn't treat you well. We should totally screw him over.
Forget it. This race is all about getting some miles under the hood. It's as much about the car's stamina and technology as it is about efficiency and reliability. That's the name of the game. This is where we see our technology from tomorrow.
Some of the teams are using it to increase car speed. Heard a few Kronstadt mechanics talking about it the other day. Something about Knox not wanting to use it because she wanted to win on her own.
Imagine that. Isn't that illegal?
I don't know. Knox ordered them to put it here, so they asked me to put it here. So I just did that. Not touching it again.
Sounds like a good idea.
Happens to it, no poking around the engine or anything
like that. Knox is a genuine technician. He's really protective about his projects. Prefers to fix everything himself, apparently. Don't worry about grabbing him, though. If anything goes awry, you'll see him down here as fast as light.
Gotcha.
Robert Knox has a race car on display in the Expo building. The show staff is under strict instructions to summon him at any sign of malfunction. Apparently, Knox trusts no one to fix his car but him. Perhaps it's time to poke around under the hood, 47. Good. I dare say this should get Knox.
that's the way to do it. I like it.
You coward!
Good. I dare say this should get Nox's undivided attention.
Huh. Why's the engine off? Let's just try to get this started again. Well, that doesn't sound good. Better call Nox. Mr. Nox? Yeah, it's Smith from down at the Expo. Listen, the Mark III's making some, well, just odd noises. Can you come? Great. All right. Yep. Yeah, I'll be here.
Heads will roll. I need you to get in the car. Don't touch anything until I tell you. What are you waiting for? Get in the car. Forget it. Step aside. I'm handling this myself. All right, let's just turn the key and see. Virtually impervious to small arms fire, the palace unit can be upgraded. Hours rather than years.
Good. I dare say this should get Nox's undivided attention.
Huh. Why's the engine off? Let's just try to get this started again. Well, that doesn't sound good. Better call Nox.
Mr. Nox? Yeah, it's Smith from down at the Expo. Listen, the Mark III's making some, well, just odd noises. Can you come? Great. All right. Yep. Yeah, I'll be here.
I swear to God, if someone's been tampering with the car, heads will roll. I need you to get in the car. Don't touch anything until I tell you. Well, you waiting for a written invitation? I told you to get in the car.
I'm afraid...
Hey, you! Trespassers will be shot. Sir, you will need to follow me. Please comply and come along.
This is very strange. It shouldn't behave like this at all. Try the engine, Smith.
Did you not hear what I said? Follow me.
All right, try it now.
This should work. Did I not make myself clear? Come here. Okay.
Ah, here we are.
Trying one more time, sir. You need to follow me right now.
Good. Hit it, Smith. Right, that's it.
Did you not hear what I said?
You see anyone, and I mean anyone, messing with the car, you call me. You hear me?
Get your ass on the ground.
Don't move.
Hands where I can see them.
I need help here, goddammit!
Are neck and neck out there.
you know, I inherited that money from my dad. I figured why not use it for something he would like. My only regret is that we never went together. He was real big on these long drives. Only had a motor. That's not good. Get in the fight. Let money out. His job is just getting really old. That's my...
What?
Hey, what's up with that racket? Somebody go and check it out.
Send for it.
It's not like I haven't been here before.
Got no idea what started it. It's over now, I guess.
Yeah? I mean, what?
The race is entering its final lap, 47.
What?
47, the race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track. Anytime now.
Hi.
Look out for the fireworks. Moses Lee will take the podium.
sure you have a great view of the celebrations from the stands.
Nice outfit. Really brings out your eyes. Miss Knox informed me you'd be
here.
She asked to make sure you brought the documents. So, did you bring the documents?
I have the papers right here.
Excellent. Come on in. Have a seat or something. I'll let Miss Knox know you're here.
So far, so good, 47. Now, let's see where this meeting is headed.
There's a guy here wearing a mascot outfit claiming you have an appointment with him.
He wouldn't give his name.
Got it. I'll let him know you're on the
Hey, Flamingo guy. Miss Knox is on her way. Have a seat somewhere. She'll be here as soon as she can. So, you here for a job application or what?
Something like that.
Nice. If you don't mind me saying so, your particular choice of attire is maybe a little, I don't know, off? For a job interview, I mean.
Nice suit is at the cleaners.
And you couldn't find anything else to wear?
Correct.
You must lead a very interesting life, my friend.
You have no idea.
So, Mr. I never did catch your name.
Names are for friends.
Very well. Straight to the point in all business. Walk with me.
Where are we going?
Greetings,
sir. Don't worry. What am I gonna do? Kill you in broad daylight. I just want a bit of privacy here. Not about to do sensitive business like this in front of an audience.
Good idea.
So just to get this straight. You claimed in your email to have somehow found internal reports that show Kronstadt's involvement in the Tungan Valley massacre.
Sounds about right.
Let's be clear. You and I are having this meeting because my father doesn't need to know about this. It's just another undesired distraction. I don't care if the information is true or false. I don't care if it mentions moving money from the Nexus project into Tungan Valley damage control, as you claimed in your correspondence. I do care about protecting my father, which is why you and I are now here.
I see.
Leave me alone for a few minutes, guys.
Sure thing, Miss Knox. If you need us, just call. We're right around the corner.
So here's the deal. You hand over the documents and leave, and that's the end of it. And you will do that now. So here are the two possible outcomes of this meeting. One, you will leave this place and this country for good, and that will be the end of it. Everyone lives happily ever after. Two, you don't choose option one. So-
Target down. Next up, Robert Knox.
Yeah, that's right, Birdman. Nobody messes with Kronstadt.
You're lucky you're not extinct.
You're almost there, folks. Almost. It's time to get your cameras and your phones ready and fire away. Get that killer shot to impress your family and friends at work.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Maxwell Rudder. I am the senior race official here at the Miami Global...
Sir, we'll work this out.
Oh, my.
Thank you.
That is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men.
Bill, it's Ted
here. Must be connected
to Kronstadt. Just returning your call before heading over to the Expo building to meet Knox for the new combat android presentation.
No, not yet. I'm letting him stew a little. The
guy's a genius, and you know what they're like. Desperately lacking any discipline or respect for other people. Last time I tried to have a meeting with him, he had me sitting in a room for 4 hours before canceling. I'll head up when I feel like it. All right, I'll call you after the presentation. Speak then.
Ted Mendez, a defense funding consultant with the U.S. military, is scheduled for a private demonstration of a new Kronstadt robotics project. Sounds like a way to get up close and personal with Robert Knox, 47.
Ah, security. You look well prepared.
Is anyone there? Who's throwing stuff around?
This is pissing me off.
Oh, hi.
Mr. Mendez. Good to see you, sir. The demonstration is scheduled to take place on the upper floors. Please feel free to use the stairs right over there. Yes, this is just to let you know I've let Mr. Mendez in. He's on his way upstairs now.
Hi, whatever.
Mr. Mendez? Right this way, sir.
Collecting pictures of celebrity entrepreneurs now, 47? What are you thinking?
Hello? HR? Yes, it's Finn Wheeler down at the Bayside Center. Listen, I realize this may sound trivial, but the Fountain View Soda Dispenser...
Ted, good to finally see you. Guess traffic was rough.
What?
Never mind. Let me show you everything. I'm gonna say something provocative now, Ted. War is going out of fashion. It's dirty, it's just plain bad PR. Nobody wants to exchange their children and loved ones for flags and medals anymore. The glory is gone, Ted. But luckily, Kronstadt has a solution for that. Imagine this. Android infiltrators operating in the field, disguised and fully embedded, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Indestructible robotic operators who can infiltrate the deepest sanctuary of any adversary, striking an unseen fatal blow, a surgical tool for a blunt world. Imagine an army of them, fully equipped android medics, seeking out wounded servicemen and injured civilians, bringing them to safety, or patching them up then and there. Android pilots delivering payloads deep inside enemy territory with uncanny precision and minimal collateral damage. All right, Mendez, it's very straightforward. Let me show you. I just pick any of the pictures on the desk, then I use the scanner to upload the biometric data, and Palace will do the rest.
Target acquired, WB.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually feeding it biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment in modern conflict solution, Ted. Palace is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table. And scan it just like I showed you. It's perfect.
Target acquired.
Damn it.
Robert Knox.
Hell.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
stole my mascot outfit. Who would do that?
Do this? Ah, Jesus Christ! Jeez!
Extent of your injuries first.
Oh, my head. Where are my clothes? Do you see my mask? Got outfit? Thank you.
not a weapon.
Berlin, Shanghai, Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
You ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray, the late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on. But before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Ah, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this hearts and flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
This is his fight too, Olivia.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Just get me inside. Rico, I need a favor.
Good morning, 47. Our Providence contact has shared the identity of the Shadow Client, a former mercenary and bodyguard by the name of Lucas Gray. His past is a black void, but our analysts are digging deep. Meanwhile, we've had a breakthrough of our own. Comparing the malicious attack patterns with global shipping and transportation routes, we've figured out how Mr. Gray and his paramilitaries move around the world undetected. They're using the distribution network of the Delgado Cartel, Colombia's biggest drug manufacturer. Clearly, Gray must have struck a deal with the Delgados. Consequently, if we can cripple the cartel, we can severely limit the militia strike range. But to do so, we need to slay a three-headed serpent. Sociopathic cartel head Rico Delgado and his two closest lieutenants, PR guru Andrea Martinez and savant chemist Jorge Franco. With equal parts guts and guile, Rico Delgado runs a thriving billion-dollar criminal empire. The word is, the brutal and volatile cartel head is hell-bent on becoming the number one drug lord in the world. To achieve this, Martinez, a childhood friend of Delgado's, has been buttering up state leaders and decision-makers, paving the way for an expansion of the Delgado logistics network, while the brilliant but aloof and antisocial Franco has been hard at work developing a new type of super cocaine. So, three of Colombia's most infamous crime lords inhabiting a decidedly hostile environment. I will leave you to prepare.
Thank you.
Welcome to Columbia, 47. The remote village of Santa Fortuna awaits you deep inside the Colombian rainforest. An iron-fisted Delgado cartel rules over the village and its surroundings. Security around Santa Fortuna and the closed-off cartel compound is extremely tight. Armed sicarios patrol the streets of the village, ready to enforce harsh punishments to those who do not comply. Rumors persist of hidden transportation cave systems connecting the village, the cartel compound, and the hidden coca fields beyond. It is a rare occurrence to have all three cartel leaders present in the village at the same time. Expect that all targets are protected by scrupulous killers, armed with automatic weapons. Rico Delgado inhabits his fortified mansion on the outskirts of the village, while Andrea Martinez can be found in her village office or around Santa Fortuna itself. And Jorge Franco is engaged in development of a new drug in his field laboratory. Happy hunting, 47.